Hi everyone, this is Alex Walker. Today I'm going to show you the brand new Avid Media Composer 7. This new release, Avid has done away with the need for separate installers for Media Composer and Symphony. Now Symphony is simply a feature set within Media Composer that needs to be activated, kind of like Phrase Find. I'm just going to really quickly walk you through using and setting up a couple of the new features that I think I'm going to be using the most. There are a lot of others. If you look in the video information below, there are links to the official Avid documentation where you can read up on the rest of them. First up, we have a new Avid Media Access link menu. There are no longer separate functions for linking to individual files or volumes. From this new menu, you simply link to files as either AMA files, individual files, or full AMA folders. For R3D users, the source settings options have been updated to include Red Color 3 and Red Gamma 3. Frame Flex is also a new addition, which allows you to crop into and pan and scan across high-res media. So say, for example, you have a wide 4K shot, but you want to punch in and get a close-up out of it. Now you can do that through the source settings menu, and it will save it as metadata. Something I've been waiting for a while in Avid has been the ability to add a lookup table to your footage. For example, this is some CineStyle 7D footage that's super flat, and I don't really want to see that while I'm editing. So you simply go to your source settings and select full range as the original color space. And then keeping in mind that Avid is working in Rec. 709, apply the appropriate conversion, and there you go. Two more really welcome additions are the abilities to transcode only the AMA linked clips in a sequence, as well as background rendering, finally. As you can see, it works like a normal transcode, except the progress bar disappears and you can continue your work. The new transcoded file shows up as offline for now, and if you want to check on your progress, just navigate to the new background queue. Dynamic media folders will make ingesting and transcoding media into a simple drag and drop operation with a little setup. Navigate to the dynamic media folders menu, create a new watch folder, and then create an action profile with your preferred transcoding options. Enable the dynamic media folder, and then use the finder to drag media into that folder. It's important to note that background services are not enabled by default. You can switch them on using the new icon in the top menu bar, which allows you to use dynamic media folders even while Avid is not running. You can check on the progress of the transcoding using the web interface. Once the background process is complete, simply go back to your Dynamic Media Folders menu and then hit the small button under the Acquire column next to the folder you just used, and your new bin with the new media will pop up. And finally, the Media tool will now show you all the AMA linked footage as well as the Avid MXF media across all of your drives for a specific project. And with that said, those are the features that I find the most compelling about Avid Media Composer 7. There are a lot of other new ones. Take a look at the documentation and the links below. Also, keep in mind that this was recorded on a 2008 MacBook Pro, so there is considerable lag on the screen recording here, which is not present in reality. Thanks for watching. This is Alex Walker. Thank you.